Caity.
Hey, Caity.
Caity was my first friend on campus. I met her during Weekend of Welcome, and we decided we were going to make cardboard boat races.
Caity is one of the kindest, brightest, warmest people I've ever known.
I was in SGA as a senator with her for a year, and then I worked with her last year when she was involved in other student orgs.
She was my neighbor in my hall, Groundheart.
Caity was a dear friend of mine and someone that I really loved a lot.
My other half.
Just her big smiles and her huge hug.
Smiling.
Caity. The smile.
Her smile.
Every time I saw her, she always had that smile.
Happiness, smiles, just cheerful moods.
And she was always funny, always laughing, always had a smile on her face. She was just the most warm-hearted person. Wasn't afraid to joke around.
Her goofiness.
She'd always light up a room when she walked in and make your day if it was not going so well.
When we got tired, things got pretty goofy.
She was always smiling, always happy, always wanted to make sure everyone was included.
Very kind.
I don't know, literally. There wasn't a single thing I got.
Her personality, she is herself. She never falters, never fades. She was always who she wanted to be and didn't let anyone change her.
The thing is her determination.
Just her love for science, her love for animals, her love for everything, you know, just life in general. It's really, really cool to see it. It was something that was rare to see.
She was always staying up late and doing homework. She was always determined to do great in her classes.
Very real, very set goals, and she was willing to do anything to get them.
The amount of value she put on people and friendships.
She had great hair.
She always was looking to help a friend, whether it was signing them up for classes or if they were having a bad day.
My favorite thing about her probably would have been that I could have told her anything.
She was super funny, super smart, gorgeous.
She always looked dang good.
There was always one person that could make my day.
That she would genuinely want the best for everybody, and she always pushed everyone to be the best that they could be. And you knew she actually meant that because she kept tabs on you to make sure that you were doing your best.
She never judged a book by its cover, but she just really cared a lot about people and placed a lot of value on them.
And she would have understood anything from, you know, the nastiest joke of all time to, just something that's just really stressing me out.
And she always responded to me in French, which was very sweet. And I really loved that because she was the one on campus that really took the time, like, to greet me in French.
I will never forget all the struggles Caity and I had throughout our classes, organic chemistry, and all the good laughs that came along with it.
We always sat next to each other and doodled on each other's notes or in each other's books as we saw fit when we couldn't focus on what the teacher was saying.
It's not everyone who would sing in a chemistry lab with you or blow bubbles off a third floor Swenson. It's not everyone who's as quirky to finish a meal based on the fact of when she was done with her milk. And it's also not everyone who would force themselves to drink coffee, even though she thinks it tastes like beans, just because she read a study that it stimulates thinking.
And every time I would see her, she would be studying in the link, and she would always give me a hard time about wanting to get a study box from me.
It was the weekend, I wanted to be lazy, had one of my friends over playing Call of Duty. She knocks on my door in sweatpants and a tank top, grabs a controller, sits down, and ended up playing with us for like 2 hours because she didn't want to study.
Yeah, because we just had so much fun, not even doing anything, just existing together and all just hanging out.
She was the one that made those times really fun and just encouraging and enjoyable, and I like them very much.
There were quite a few times when I first met her, she would make fun of me because I didn't know how to spell her name. So every time I would see her, she would make me like spell her name out to her because I would always struggle with it.
She was full of experience and she told me that one of these days she might even think of passing by Cameroon where I'm from. So I was really gonna say, okay, let's make it a plan.
We'd just be so tired after a long day, and the things that would come out of our mouths were just should not have been said. Good stuff, though. Good stuff.
That Caity was wonderful and happy and determined, and I hope to carry that through my life in memory of her.
As much as she was able to inspire while she was still around, I think one of the most amazing things that I'm seeing is how much everyone is still inspired, that we still get to celebrate her life this long after that. There's still this big push, I think about her all the time, like the things that she did.
I mean, she marked my life anyway. She was part of it, and I will always remember that you have to be smiley every day.
And she was someone that that really never stopped inspiring you, in everything that she did.
She taught me things that I'll carry for the rest of my life.
All those dreams that we have, all those things, she was someone who made it very real.
I'm just really, really honored that I had the opportunity to know her, and very thankful that she was here for the time that she was.
The few moments I had with her was very, very blessed. That's what I can say. I'm really, 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 really blessed.
Caity, you'll be missed.
Bonjour, comment vas-tu? Ça va? Ça va bien. I'm really gonna miss that. I'm really gonna miss that.
This other thing that I remember much about Caity is how much she loved you guys.
And I feel like something's missing, There's an empty spot over there, but I know it's just a goodbye, and then I know I'm gonna see you soon.
That Caity knew her savior. So now she's up in heaven, partying with the Lord with great hair, and just having a great life.
She's in our house. She's that angel that still guides us from above us.
I will miss her.
I miss her, and I'll never forget her.
We love you, we miss you, we know you're looking down on us, and we will see you some.
I love you, Caity.
Forever.